Hello and welcome students, my name is Shampa. Today we are going to make an interesting conversion. We are going to convert decimal number system to octal conversion. Now the question arises, a very important question, why do we need this octal conversion? Why do we need the octal number system in the first place? Decimal number systems use numbers from 0 to 9. So it uses 10 numbers, that is 0, 1 to 9. Whereas octal numbers uses numbers from starting from 0 to 7. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are the numbers used by the octal number system. So it takes less space. So it is easy to make a conversion from octal to binary and binary to octal. So let's see, how do we convert decimal number system to octal number system? Let's begin. Let's say we have a number 71 in the decimal number system. Let's convert it into octal number system. Let the number in the octal number system be 8 and we will convert it in the octal number system. Let's begin. First of all, we will divide 71 by 8. If we divide 71 by 8, the quotient is going to be 8 and the remainder is going to be 7. Now we have the quotient 8, we will divide it by 8 again. And we will keep on dividing till the quotient is 0. I repeat again, till the quotient is 0. Now if we divide by 8 by 8, we will get the quotient as 1. And the remainder is going to be 0. This time it's going to be 0. Now we have the quotient 1. We will divide it by 8 again. This time we know 8 into 0 is 0, so this time the quotient is going to be 0 and the remainder is 1. So our number in the octal number system is going to be in this direction. So it's going to be 1, 0, 7. This is the number we have in the octal number system. That was easy. Let's take one more example. Let's take a random number, let's say 257. Now let's convert 257 to its octal form. So let's do it. We will divide 257 by 8. So the quotient, let's represent it by Q. Quotient is going to be 32 and remainder is going to be 1. Let's divide 32 by 8 again. We will keep on dividing till the time we get the quotient as 0. This time the quotient is 4. And the remainder is 0. We have the quotient as 4. We will divide it by 8. And 8 into 0 is 0. So this time we got the quotient as 0. And the remainder is 4. Now, the number in the octal system for 257, 257 is the number in the decimal system, and for octal system, the number we have is 401. This is the number. I'm sorry, this is the number in the octal system. That's why I wrote 8 at the base. So this is how we convert numbers from decimal system to the octal system. That was easy. Now, I would request you to try some more numbers. Let's say 27, 251, 1032, 599. That's it. And please write the answers in the comment section. That's it for the day. Thank you.